नमस्ते डॉक्टर कारप्पन सर एंड डॉक्टर नारायण सर एंड थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर दी विवा स्वयं यूट्यूब विच इज गिवन मी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग दी हैंडलूम इंडस्ट्री वेर वी आर ईगरली वेटिंग फॉर द हैंडलूम डे सेलिब्रेशन एंड हियर लाइक आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस अ लॉट अबाउट सस्टेनेबिलिटी ऑफ हैंडलूम इंडस्ट्री. सो आई एम डॉक्टर सुनंदा कलकन ओवर हियर एंड आई एम अ टेक्सटाइल एंड फैशन डिजाइनर एंड रिसेंटली आई बी नॉमिनेटेड एज अ सिंडिकेट मेंबर फॉर कर्नाटक जनपद विश्वविद्यालय दैट्स इन कर्नाटक एंड माई वर्क गिव मेड मी टू बी एन एंटरप्रीनर एंड नाउ हियर व्हाई आई सिलेक्टेड दिस टॉपिक इज बिकॉज वी आर हियरिंग सो मेनी थिंग अबाउट द हैंडलूम हैंडलूम एंड देन देवर एग्रीकल्चर आर द टू फेसेस ऑफ अ कॉइन एंड हैंडलूम वीवर एंड देन द फार्मर सिचुएशंस आर ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर And both are dying. But at one time, if you consider the ancient time, and yesterday I was seeing your video about a madam who was explaining about our history of the handloom industry, which was an excellent one, and where it has started, how it has started. So we can see so much of technicality and the skill in the handloom weavers. And we were so rich in the raw materials and everything at one time. But due to this, what you call the industrialization and modernization, it has affected to a greater extent to our economy as well as our art of our handloom weavers and then our traditions and culture. So we were earlier like we were completely we were into the natural form and eco balance was very good. We used to use only the naturally grown materials and everything. This industrialization modernization has like developed many non like chemical related raw materials. Either it might be our fiber, which is made up of petrochemicals and polyester materials, and then dyes made up of the chemicals. So, which is all affected our thousand year old nature and environment and the eco balances. So, now we are moving back to our traditions wherein we can just have our eco friendly raw materials, eco friendly dyes, eco friendly what you call the fibers. So we were having only the pure cottons, pure silks, which were actually very rich, and we used to for like and weave a very fine cotton, which is like almost transparent, and the mull material, which is of having around 400 counts, which nowadays is very difficult. Hardly you can see about 1%, which is existing that in a remote area, and nobody is working on it for its survival. So now the sustainability has become a question. Once weavers were the rich persons, it used to be in a colony, like it used to be like an industry, and it used to be for the purpose of the particular village or particular community or particular cluster. Now it has taken up a business model, so which has affected to a great extent. So we had a great power of our handloom, whether skill is there, technicality is there, and we have the even the, we can modify as per the requirement for one sari or for one product. We can change the loom settings. We can do any modifications in the loom very easily, and our handloom articles are very luxury items, and they were all like an exclusive, having the designs. Each artisan used to produce a variety in it. There were the competition, like yeah, you are doing this, and then I'll do this. So you are doing this, I'll do still more finer than this. So that was the competition we had at one time. So now what had happened is because of these. Entry of modern industrialization and entry of the power looms and everything, the our handloom industry has almost died, I can say. That's what we are hearing from our great Dr. Nihar sir. He was telling that still there are a number of handloom weavers are there in our particular area and they were not seeing any problem. But still, why the weavers conditions are so pathetic? Why they're so poor? Is the question mark I have in mind. So there are so many threats and there is no research you need for it. And we are having the handloom industry since ancient time. But do we have a coach for them? Do we have an education for them? Do we have any welfare for them? So this all had combined and compiled together affected our handloom industry to a great extent. And the threats I have mentioned, so many threats. There is no self-centeredness in the weavers or the self-centeredness in the programs and the techno. There is a lot of technology gap. There is no financial support for the weavers, either by themselves or by the societies or by the government. So we made a small SWOT analysis of our handloom industry. To look at it, we have a great strength in the handloom industry. We have a great creativity in mind. So we don't have the, like in early, we never had this jacquard attachment, electronic jacquard and other things. But our weavers were so creative. They used to make a portrait of a person. The person as the Rajas and whoever is there, however they stand, the same, the format they used to weave in the loom. That was only the hand. We were not having any advanced technologies. That was the skill and creativity. And they used to weave all the animals, sceneries, everything we used to see, like in the ancient pictures, if we see, everything was there. But now that creativity we are missing because of the commercialization, I can say. And we were having only the natural raw materials were used to be used on the looms. Natural colors were there. Where was the synthetic color before the 18th century? Synthetic colors were invented in the 17th and 18th century. By then onwards, we are seeing all this synthetic and the chemical dyes. So imagine the synthetic industry has affected the, which is around just 2 centuries old, has affected our 1000 century old nature and the health and everything of the globe. Either take it from the sky to the ground or the underground, even the fishes of the aquatic and non-aquatic creatures also finding a lot of difficulties. This is mainly because of our the invention of the so many like a cost effective and the cheap materials of the synthetic. And then strength is that we are the employers. When we are the employers, the handloom industries provide a great employment opportunity to a number of people, and we have a great market. We cannot say that we don't have a market for the handloom. Handloom has a great market, and resource and the skill is an the added advantage for the strength of the handloom industry, and it is completely eco-friendly. It is not harming any of our nature. Because whatever the raw materials are there, whatever the loom parts are there, they are all made up of wood and the eco-friendly materials. And coming to the weakness main thing is the market linkage. Because of the entry of the the industrialized machineries of the power loom and the mill sector, so they started taking the advantage of the handlooms. Nowadays also, in the name of the handloom, power loom and mill fabrics are being sold. They are showing majority of the businesses are selling the handloom and power loom material and the mill material as an handloom material. See how much market we have for our handloom products. And then we don't have any infrastructure, and ours is a decentralized unit. Earlier we were not decentralized. They used to come to and one shed. They used to have a one colony like. But now it has been like a decentralized by many of the, I can say, I don't know whether it is because of the politics or because of what it is. So we need to understand why it has been decentralized first. Every time we are using it as decentralized. And if we see about 60 year history back or around 40 years back, each house used to have around 20 to 40 loops per one in a shed, in a nut shed, or in a one family used to give an opportunity for those people in only one, under one roof, I can say. So, but they've all been, almost all have been lost. Now we are hearing only about around 2 looms, 4 looms, and so on. And the weakness is major is R&D and education. Our weavers are not getting the education. Earlier, there was like a tradition they used to pass on, they used to teach to whoever they are interested. Now, as they are not getting the money, the value for the right product, so they are not allowing their children also to continue in it. So R&D is a major requirement for the handloom industry, and non-availability of quality of raw materials. And agriculture also has affected a lot. We are not getting the quality of cotton, quality of silk and starch material. Either it might be the jawar starch or the rice starch. So we tried in one of the area wherein we wanted to restart the single yarn. That's 80 count single yarn with a starching, but we could not get the starch, which we could not extract the starch of the best quality, which we used to get in the earlier from the agriculture fields. So that also has been contaminated now. And apart from that, the important one is the profit sharing is not reaching the grassroots worker. So opportunities, we have n number of opportunities. We have an international market, we have a possibility for expansion, we have the customize, we can customize our products to a great extent, and we can diversify our handloom products at any stage, and we have a less tax compared to the others. So even though we have so many strength and opportunities, our weakness and the threats are affecting our industry to a great extent. So see the threat, manpower retention. So people are not coming to view back because they are not getting the amount to be paid for them. They are finding it very difficult to live their life. And it is our unit, the handloom industry is hard labor oriented, and as per the labor intensive, but there is no income for them. So commercialization has affected to a great extent. Even though we have a GI tax, but the same GI tag has been like in given woven on the power loom. So when woven on the power loom, the cost of the production will become low. Automatically, the public or they will be put up in the high, saying that yeah, this is the ilkal. For example, this is an ilkal sari. You can get it to 500 and 600. Wherein the handloom sari will cost it around 1200 to 1300. So that commercialization or that has affected to a great extent our handloom industry. So then coming to the facts about the handloom industry. So we know that like even though handloom is an ancient industry, do we have an exclusive institute for it? So we have hardly around in I think Venkatgiri we have, and in Salem we have, in Tamil Nadu we have one or two institute, but are they contributing to a great extent to the weaving community? So that is the biggest question mark. Even though there are handloom weavers are there, we are in the recent COVID time, we are hearing about more number of deaths due to non-repayment of the amount what they have taken as a loan or something. They're finding it very difficult to run a family. But what is the reason why it is so, and other things we need to think a lot about it. And apart from that, do we have an R&D, as I just discussed, do you have an R&D research and development unit for our handloom industry? But we have for the mill sector, we have for the power loom, but why not for the handloom? When everybody portrayed it as a handloom industry is a big industry which is contributing 45 million of an employment opportunities, it contributes to the GDP, and then where it is. So we need to have an education, best education system, and an R&D unit exclusively for the handloom industry. And then we need to develop the handloom industry in the like our ancient system, in the either it might be in the PPT triple P mode, or it might be in the producer company mode. So whatever mode we need to get into the platform, and we need to work on it. So, and another important thing is that GI production. So we are tying the technical or the skilled products under the GI. Ilkal saris are under GI, some kanchi saris are under the GI. But why they are allowed to be woven on the power loom? Then who will tie the knot for them? Who will catch hold of the power loom weavers who are doing all the GI tagged products on the power loom? So there are so many questions on this. And the handloom industry, neither it is considered as a labor intensive, or neither it comes under the labor law, neither it comes under the MSME. So nowhere it is considered. So then how the industry will improve? Then the handloom industry will improve. Who will reward and recognize them? So the major constraints are, the constraints are there in all the three categories. We have a pre-loom constraint, we have on-loom constraint, and we have the post-loom constraint. So pre-loom, so we are not getting the quality, and automatically whatever the mills and then the industries are spinning the yarn with a mixture of the synthetic, we are getting those yarns into our handlooms for weaving. And then on the loom, we don't have much of the technologies, we are not making much of the variations in it. And are we getting any incentives for the handloom weavers? And then post-loom, what is the market linkage? What is the value addition we are doing? But still we can see in the market that there are so many industries which are like, and so many NGOs are there, so many industries are there, so many governments are there, so many NIFT, NID, design institutes are there. But still, why is the condition of the handloom weavers is so pathetic? So I have these questions in mind. Who can answer me? What will happen to handloom industry in the next coming generations? Who will be the future weavers? What will attract handloom weavers to remain as weaver and generation after generation? How do we preserve our tradition? What mix will make handloom survive? Where and when we have to start, and who will start? This is the biggest questions in my mind. So we need to have a brainstorming sessions on these, so that we can employ, like, and we can make the handloom industry in the topmost of our, to contribute to a great extent to our GDP, and to have an eco-friendly environment, and to contribute to the eco balances. So these are my few of the problem statements. So why handloom weavers are dying? What is made them. So the main reason they tell, even though they are skilled, they are talented. So what is that? It is hindering them. It is only the thing is that they are not getting the value for their product. For example, Ilkal sari will take around 12 hours on an average 2 days to weave one sari. And the weaving charge for the handloom is around maximum is 450. And to weave one sari, minimum 2 to 3 members are required for the pre-loom and on-loom processes. Imagine per day, per weaver, will earn around 100 to 150. Then why? Then why have they have to do the in the, this handloom weaving when they are not getting paid? So because of these problems, so many have they shifted their handloom weaving, their job from weaving to the like and just a BD shops, then the roadside hotels, dhabas, as in security guards, as a cleaners. So many things. It is so they are so talented, but they don't want to work there. They want to come back to weaving. But who will show them the route? Where is the route? So this all made me to think. And we are having, and if you check the report of the government reports, government schemes are, some of the schemes are excellent schemes, but it is not reaching to the grassroots level. Why? It is mainly because I can say here, and if anybody is hurt, I'm sorry for that. But here the main reason is that even though the government schemes are good, the government employees are not working to the point where they have to work. They are not working to the duty, or they are not doing their duty for what they have been paid. See the recent Karvi the survey. For example, in our area itself, that's in Amminkad, if I consider, I'm staying in a weaver family. They are the basic weavers, they are the weavers, and they do daily handloom weaving. Their name is not there in the list of a Karvi. Then whom we have to blame? Whether we have to blame Karvi, whether we have to blame the department, whether we have to blame the societies. We have in one village for around 300 to 500 handloom weavers, we have around 10 to 13 societies. Is it required? Then where that amount is rotating in terms of crores every year? If you see the reports of the government, so much and so much of a crores amount has been spent on the development of the handloom industry. Then why the handloom weavers have not been upgraded? Why they have not been taken to the platform? Then where the amount is going? This is the greatest question mark in the minds. So this is made me to think, suggest and plan for a certain solution. So the main sustainability handloom works only we think in terms of man, machine, material, market and money. That's a 5M. If you work on this, we can have a solution for it. To do all this, thinking about all this, in 2015, I started a small project on my own. That is selecting one cluster in Telangana, and which have left out with only about 3 to 4 weavers in 2014 and 15. So about if we left it, it was about to like and die the technicality of weaving that particular technology or the particular skill or the particular handloom art, traditional handloom art was about to die. So I made a lot of research on it, and I was in need of a support that time. I am very much thankful to my University of Agriculture Sciences, Dharwad, that's in Karnataka, which has financially supported me to do a research, like to do a research in Telangana. The amount from Karnataka University of Agriculture Sciences, Dharwad, has sponsored me to do a research in Telangana, wherein Telangana did not actually support me in doing that research. I inquired many people but could not get the support. But I am very much thankful to the team of Dr. Geeta Mahalay, Dr. Hunshal sir, Dr. Biradar sir, Dr. Chetty sir, and all the related persons who actually helped me to do this project. So now what I made, whatever the solutions I what the solutions where you can do, like how you can improve the how you can sustain the traditional art and uplift the handloom weavers. This is a simple the digitization process I did. So this is our traditional art, and this was the motif. So which I just converted into this lady using a simple hand no textile design software was used. Only the Photoshop software was used to digitize it. So I modified the design as per the market requirement, modified the design as per the need of the customers. And here, this is the basic handloom. So in this handloom, they used to use a Jala technology. I think those who are in handloom, they know about it, how they used to make a designs on the looms before entry of the jacquard. Jala technique was a tedious technique wherein to make this motif, they used to take around to weave one sari, they used to take around 1 week. So we modified the loom with an upgraded technology of a jacquard. So here the design modification has been done, and then the handloom upgradation has been done. So doing all this, we converted our Golabama, traditional Golabama design, into a beautiful lady. So this has got a good market. So they said, everybody said that it is a very good design, Sunanda. It has a good market and everything. So this is the Jala technique, so which earlier they used to weave. So this used to take around 6 days to weave one sari, and after incorporation of the jacquard, now they can weave in 3 days of one sari. So almost around, I can say, 50% cut down in the production time. So, and apart from that, even the threads used to lift very easily, and we gave them a little bit of a skill upgradation training so that they can do it at a faster rate. So with all these, we modified the products, we diversified the products from sari, from small design to a bigger design, from sari to dupatta to fabric material, and even we made the gift items here, and even we made the pouches out of it, and even we made the fashion garments. We did a fashion show to promote the handlooms. So that was the greatest strength of us. So all this contributed to the awards for the handloom weavers on Handloom Day in 2017 and 18. So these two are my weavers. He is Mr. Satya and he is Mr. Kailasam. Actually, those really worked hard for the thing, for this development of diversifying the products and then bringing back the Golabama into the platform. And looking into this, and we got a good publicity thanks to media of Telangana, who actually helped us in publicizing our work. And Vanita TV covered our program for a half an hour, and the ministers of Telangana really appreciated our work, and we requested them for the support, but it's our bad luck, I can say, we did not get the support. But I'm thankful to University of Agriculture Sciences for the support, and this all this helped us to give a best platform for the handloom weavers. And in this process of the 2 years, handloom weavers who were earning around, on an average, around 5,000 to 7,000, now they're earning almost double. So last around, before the lockdown, my one more weaver, Mr. Nagbhushan, had called me one evening time and said, "Madam, do you know how much I'm earning this month?" So I was so happy to hear that he has earned around 22,000 per month. So then what else I can require? The smile on the face of the weavers is the best and is the success of a project. And now it has become a benchmark there. So those who are weaving the traditional handloom Golabama sarees, so their weaving charges have been increased, and almost all of them are happy, whomever I have met. So they are saying, "Madam, meer vacharu, meer vachin tarvata manaki chala help ayindi, new band mele nanu tumba help agide, new bandid mele namgella designs ela modify madidivi, namdella salary chenagagide." So they are so happy with those statements, and they are happy with the revival art. And now government has come forward and it has given 20 looms to that area, and now the weaving of the traditional Golabama has restarted it. See the market potential, how much market potential we have. This is only about the handloom industry, and that is taking only about the IBEF report. So which is the financial export was around, imagine, almost $344 million, only the export, imagine. So this much of the market potential the handloom industry has. And why then industry is dying? Why the weavers are leaving? We have so much of competition in the market. There are so many NGOs working. There are so many individual outlets. There is so much of e-platform. If you just Google, you will see in terms of lakhs of the Facebook, lakhs of WhatsApp groups, lots of websites which are saying that we are promoting handlooms, we help handlooms, and Amazon is doing, Flipkart is doing. But still, my question is, why handloom weavers are dying? When we can do with a small amount and the support from the US Dharwad Karnataka to a great extent, then why not the government and the so many CSR funds and then NGOs, why not they are doing it? Where the amount is going, what the government is doing, this is my question. And we are so different, but even though there is so much of competition, still we can compete and we can bring back our handloom to a great platform. See, so this is, we had an opportunity to exhibit in an international exhibition at Hitec City, Telangana, Hyderabad, and thanks to Telangana government for giving us this opportunity, and thanks to special thanks to Venkatreddy Garu from the Telangana government, who actually helped us in like in putting up this exhibition. So here you can see that from fiber to from fabric to the finished garments. So one in all, it is exclusively with the natural dyed yarns, which is completely an eco-friendly collection and eco-friendly products. And this has a great national and international international market. So when we have so much things, then why we are not bringing up the handloom weavers is my question. So all these, the marketing strategies, that is the direct selling, then word of mouth, then the exclusive exhibitions and B2C, B2B, digital media, digital marketing, social media. If you utilize all things, so then we can give a best platform to the handloom weavers. And this is the pathetic condition of the Siddipet area in one of the societies. See how it is. It's almost like in the upper mud is falling. They have had some protection for their loom. So they are doing the single weft earth, and see the conditions of the loom here. Why we are not giving them the infrastructure? When the government and when it is contributing to the GDP, why it is not? And see the condition of the in Karnataka, North Karnataka, this is in Amminkad area. See how they are weaving. So the lady is doing the pre-processing of the loom, and the husband is weaving here, and the son is studying, but still he helps in bobbin winding and other thing. See this process, see the condition of there. Why? Why there is no infrastructure for these people? So looking into that, I started after the success of story of my Siddipet area, we started the work in the Amminkad, wherein this is the traditional loom and this is the traditional kasari. So which the pallu looks similar on both the sides, and the technique is called as a kondi technique. And shuttle weaving will be done here. So we have diversified from this basic design to these many variations from saris to dupatta, and even we are planning for the still diversification. We just started this as a startup in 2019, and because of lockdown we are facing a lot of problems. So then what is the need of the hour? So need of the hour is the give a platform to the handloom weavers, give them the share in the market along with the wages. So when you can market the product at higher end, give them the support, that is, and recognize their work and recognize their talent, recognize their skill, give recognition to them, bring them front to the floor, so that they say, yeah, I am a handloom weaver, I can do more. So I need a support. They don't need much of this. So they need a little bit of a support. So now it's a time to come back to the industrialized sector. So we need to, from decentralized, we need to have make it into a handloom industry, not as a handloom decentralized sector. So in this, it require only the process lines, operation plans and the business plans, and then the revenue models. So we need to think about this. So we already had these process plans, operation plans in the stage. So we started at Amminkad area and looking into that. Now we are doing the business plan wherein the weavers also will get a share in our profit. So that model, and then how we can generate the revenue, how we can increase the cost of the product, and how we can increase the weaving charges of the handloom weavers. So all these models we are just thinking in the COVID time, and we are going to restart in the coming another 15 days at Amminkad area. So there is a lot of things need to be worked for the handloom weavers. And thank you very much to Dr. Karappan sir, Dr. Narayan sir, and Vivasam YouTube, so the giving me an opportunity to work on it. So thank you so much, sir. If you have any questions, I would like to have the questions.
Yes, madam. Very super. Very good, madam. Very, very nice super, presentation, super, madam.
Thank yes, you, sir. Madam. Sir, apart from yes, this, madam. I forgot to tell you one more thing. And there is no unity in the weavers. So the cooperative societies of the respective area, then the department people, central and government. So there is no coordination. So unless there is no coordination, we cannot bring forward the handloom weavers. So we need to have some strategy wherein we can work for the weavers and not for the bureau, not for the high-end or the traders or anybody else. So thank you.
Yes, madam. Yes, madam.
Super. 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 Yes, madam.
Thank you, sir. Can I stop?
If you like my videos, kindly subscribe and share with your friends, and also getting more videos from my channel to press the bell button.